Hey everybody, welcome. Are you ready for this live workshop? I'm so ready. Do you see I built a fire? I am dressed in white, ready to welcome the new year in. And I can't wait to share with you everything. So turn up the volume, get your notebook out. I've got like huge pieces of paper. I've got all my massive rolls of paper. I have all my amazing markers. Say hi if you're here. Let me know where you're tuning in from. If you're watching the replay, also say hi. Today, oh my gosh, you guys, today is live stream workshop. I'm talking about how to hit your big goals in 2017. And the first thing I want to do is share this. So if we haven't met yet, let me do that first. I'm obviously excited. If we haven't met yet, my name's Emily Benson. I am a best-selling author of the Ultimate Boutique Handbook. I am founder of Stylish and Successful, and I was a mobile retail pioneer with the business called The Fashion Truck. So I have been in business for a while. I started out my retail career right after college, and I worked in corporate retail for many, many years, and then I got laid off and started the fashion truck business. And I was one of the first people in the country to have a mobile boutique, which then got me into Forbes and InStyle magazines. I did quite well in my business. And now I want to teach you how to run an amazing business. Now, today, you're more than welcome to stay on if you're not a boutique owner. Obviously, I love boutique owners because that's what I am. That's what I live and breathe so much of the time. But really in the past year and a half, I've been so much more into personal development. And I've really dug deep, studied with some of the best people in the industry with personal development. And I want to share with you some of these things that you're not learning in other business courses. I want to share some things that you're not learning from just like posting in Facebook groups, or maybe you're not learning in Facebook groups. Because the deal is right now, you guys, is that this 2017 could be huge for you. It will be huge for you. If you're here, if you're watching, it's going to be, because I'm going to show you exactly the steps how to get whatever you want this year. Are you excited? Give me some hearts if you're excited. Say hi if you're here. I want to be able to say hi. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to share this. I have two Facebook groups. Okay, so I have one that's called the Fashion Truck Tribe, aptly named, of course. And that Fashion Truck Tribe is open to anyone who's into retail. Share to a page. Anyone who's in retail. So you could be in e-commerce, you could be a mobile retailer, you could be a brick and mortar retailer. Do I have any retailers on right now? Tell me the name of your business. I have lots of people that watch my replays, so feel free to post the name of your business below. So if you're not in the Fashion Truck Tribe yet, I invite you to join. It's my free community where I provide lots of free support, actually. And I keep it high vibe all the time. There's like no negativity. Hey, Clydene. Hi from Westford. Yeah, Westford. What's up? I grew up in Westford, so of course it's close to my heart. And I'm just a few towns away right now. This past year, you guys, let me tell you, I have traveled over 20,000 miles with my boyfriend. We have been hiking in the mountains of Guatemala to shopping at Chanel in Paris, and it's been an absolutely insanely awesome year for me. So that's why I'm doing this today, because I'm really like so sick of seeing people. Hi, Tim. Welcome. I'm so freaking sick of seeing people say, I can't wait till 2017 is over. Why? Or 2016. I'm sorry. Time to tune in. I'm sharing this in my groups. I'm just on my computer here. Tune in. I'm letting people know. Time to go. Here we go. So I'm really sick of seeing this, you guys, the like hammers on the 2016, like the when is 2016 going to be over? Like, I had an amazing 2016, and I'm not saying that to brag. I'm saying that to show you that like you can create whatever year you want. I know this year was hard with the election going on. I know it was, you know, for some people they had lots of massive change. Thanks, Tim. I know that it was a big year of change for a lot of people. And that's okay. Because 2017, energetically, astrologically, all my spiritual teachers are saying that 2016 is going to be massive. So this is the exact right time for you to sit down, right? Tomorrow's the new year. I didn't want to wait till the new year to do this. Hi, Laura. Happy New Year. I hope you're having fun on your trip. I didn't want to wait. This is something we can't wait on, okay? And there's a reason I hit all my goals this year. I went to Paris. I went to Guatemala. We spent the entire fall traveling up and down the west coast of California through Mexico. You guys, like, anyone can do whatever they want. And fine, whatever. I probably sound so cheesy. Hi, Donna. Hey, how are you? Great to see you here. I probably sound so cheesy, but you know what? I don't talk enough about the idea that you can do whatever you want. When I started my fashion truck business, so many people, and not my friends or family. My friends or family are, you know, they kind of understand that I do what I want. And that's my other Facebook group. If you're an entrepreneur, if you're just wanting to get some motivation, my other group is called I Do What I Want. And I have for entrepreneurs on there too, but you don't have to be an entrepreneur. You can join that group and get really great motivation from me, because if you know me, if you met me in person, if you've watched any of my videos, I am an eternal optimist. I am extremely positive. But a few years ago, I definitely fell into a rut. I fell into a place where I wasn't really having a great time in life. I was a little bit stuck. From the outside, it definitely looked like I had everything. I had two stores. I have a great boyfriend. I have an amazing family who supports me no matter what. But I knew that something inside had to change. Like, I just knew something was off. And I actually started working with a coach who taught me a lot of what I'm going to teach you. And that first coach kind of led me to other coaches, to other books, to other teachers. And what I've really found, like, beyond anything else, what I've really found is that the journey of your life and in your business as well is a lot about personal development. Who are you in this world? What are you meant to be doing? And maybe you're perfectly happy. Maybe you're like, Emily, I don't really want to change anything. I'm great. Awesome. I still feel like there might be things that, you know, maybe you want more of, or maybe you want less of. Maybe you want less negativity in your life. Maybe you want more abundance. Maybe you want more free time with your family. There's super simple tips that I'm going to share with you today that you can do this no matter who you are. You don't have to be an entrepreneur. You don't have to be in a place where you want to make millions of dollars, or you want to travel the world. Like, you know, dreams are individual. And that's what's so cool about them, is that everyone's allowed to have dreams. We're all human. We're all allowed to do what we need, do what we want in this life. And that's the coolest thing, I think, about being a human on our planet right now, right? So I'm going to share this also really quickly in my group called the I Do What I Want Club, because I eternally do whatever I want. And I am just so excited. So let's start off. This is really a three-step process, okay? And I'm going to close up here. I'm going to see, I think I can see your comments. If anyone has comments, let me see. Hi, Tim. Hi, Claudine, Laura, Donna. Awesome. Okay, cool. So I see some people are on here. I'm psyched that you're here. So step number one, I'm going to break this down. I try to make my workshops and webinars really easy and manageable, right? So there's one thing that if you can do this today, I would love you to do it. There's actually a reason I'm burning a fire in the back. It's not snowing. It's really not even that cold here in Massachusetts. Hi. Hey, Torsha. How are you? I'm burning that fire because it's time to burn the crap that's hanging out from 2016. It's time to ditch the shit. It's time to let go of whatever you are holding on to. And I'm going to show you a really simple process that I actually did. I did this like 2 days ago, and I feel amazing since I did it. So I'm going to show you. I'm going to set up my paper here, and I'm going to turn. I've got this cool like easel paper, guys, and I should have gotten more coasters because those seem to work well. So I have this really great paper. It's the big easel paper, right? Like all kids use it, but this is what I use for goal setting. This is what I use for visual mapping. So we're going to talk a little bit about visual mapping today. Here's one of the visual maps. I recently did this the other day. So I'm a visual person. If you're creative like I am, you're probably visual too. And I think this is a great thing. Sarah just joined. Sarah, this would be something cool to do with your kids in your classroom too, right? Like I said, this would kind of apply to anyone, and I totally mean it. Especially being so creative, really fun to grab some markers, grab a big sheet of paper. And the first step is to let go of anything that's holding you back, or you feel like anything that you want to just get rid of, right? Like it could be anything around money, a relationship. Maybe you've been feeling really overwhelmed this past year, or you feel like really busy all the time. Those are things that we can start to release and let go of. And today's an awesome day to do that. So let me show you. I'm going to turn my camera down really quickly because I want to be able, if I can figure it out. I just got this awesome new tripod. So let's see. Can I figure out how to do it? Okay. I think it's here. So I'm addicted to markers too, Donna. I just bought these new, the Mr. Sketch smelly ones, and they're super awesome. Okay, so that's not working. I'm just gonna go like this, guys, okay? So I'm gonna use my tripod awkwardly. Okay, so here on this piece of paper, I highly suggest at the top, you just write something like, I'm completely, and I stole this from my friend Cameo, completely complete with what? Okay. And on this, this is why I love colors. So, not making enough money. Worrying about my kids. Completely complete with not putting myself first. Right? So, guys, I have a whole bag of markers because I'm crazy about markers. But this is the first step, okay? This is the first step to starting to let go of what you're holding on to. And I love the markers because, you know what? I actually found myself the other day when I was doing this exercise. I was sitting right here. I had the fire going. And I actually found myself grabbing certain colors, like instinctually for certain areas of my life. So for the green color, I was like, I am like done, you know, worrying about money. I'm done. It ended up being all about money, green, right? Red ended up being like about myself, you know, how I felt about myself. I'm done feeling like I shouldn't come on camera every day. I'm done feeling like I need to look perfect all the time, or I need to look a certain way to be able to be on camera, right? Certain things like that. That's the first step here, guys, is to be done. What are you done with? What are you done with? Type in the comments below just like one thing that you're totally done with. Declare it right here, live to everyone who's watching, right? Declare that right now live. Because here's the thing. We all have things that we need to ditch, right? Like old beliefs that maybe aren't ours. They're other people's. Or they're our parents, or they're our culture that we grew up in. I find sometimes I work with clients who they grew up in a different country, or they grew up in a different religion, and certain things can kind of come through, right? Certain things, certain limiting beliefs can come up through that. So yes, I love this. I'm seeing some come in. Okay. So Chrissy, you're complete being afraid of success. That's an awesome one. I love that. You know what? A lot of times too, what we find is like being afraid of success can also be afraid of failing. I know failure for me has always been like a really big topic that I don't like to fail, even though I failed a lot. And it's never ruined me. So you have permission to be successful, Chrissy. I love that. Okay, so Clydene, people who don't listen. Ooh, that's a good one. Completely complete with people who don't listen. So, you know, Clydene, something you can start to add into your life that's kind of popping into my head right now is you could start saying an affirmation, something like, I only attract people who listen completely to me. I desire to only interact with people who listen to me and hear me fully, right? Because sometimes that's it too, is that people don't totally like hear us. Maybe they're listening, but they're not really listening. So I love that. I love that. That's beautiful. Okay, Ellen. Hi, Ellen. Good to see you. Ellen is done with comparing herself and her boutique to anyone else. That's awesome. That's awesome. It's comparison is killer, because what I've found, and I'm definitely a victim to comparing myself to others, what I find is that when I look outside at other people, it just puts me in this place of self-doubt. And I actually, on my list the other day, I wrote, I'm done doubting myself. I'm totally done doubting myself. And so when we compare ourselves, it just like, it doesn't serve us. So that's a really, really awesome one to let go of, because I think at the end of the day, you know, again, some of this is a little bit of my like spiritual, like law of attraction stuff, right? At the end of the day, when we are comparing ourselves, we're not really, that's not serving us. Right? So to let that go and to say like, I'm on my own journey, I'm on my own path, that it really can't be compared to anyone else, right? It's sort of like, I know a lot of moms say this, like they'll say things like, each kid in my family is different, right? Like every one of my children is different and I have to interact with them differently, right? It's a really good kind of representation of the fact that we're all different and we're all on completely different journeys. And, you know, Jane Doe over there and Jimmy Dean over there, you know, they're not going to have the same journey in this life that we do, right? So a lot of that comparison is also just accepting that our journey is going to be different than other people's, right? I know my journey is not like my sister's. We are so much alike and we are so different all at the same time. But that's also what makes like our world really cool and beautiful, right? So yes, I went on a tangent, but definitely let's be done with comparing ourselves. I'm in with you on that one too, Ellen. I like that. Donna, being afraid of perfectionism. So being afraid of perfectionism, I like that one. You know what? I'll let you in on a little secret. Humans aren't meant to be perfect. Like, we are meant to be hot messes, generally, right? And I think like this idea of perfectionism is something I've absolutely struggled with. And I had a coach this year say to me, and I say this too, if you're in any of my groups, if you're in any of my one-on-one coaching or in my six-figure blueprint, you'll hear me say, I'm a recovering perfectionist. Like, I still have a little bit of it in me, right? Like, if you see my handwriting, I'm still like, oh, it should be a little more perfect than that, right? We love that. Yeah, thanks for the hearts and likes. Yeah, I'm a recovering perfectionist. Like, we're not meant to be perfect, and that's totally okay. So I love that, Donna, because I think, you know, I think that this is the time to give up things that aren't serving you. And sorry, I'm just trying to make sure that my hair isn't blocking my mic, or like making ruffly noises. So definitely giving up perfectionism. Love, love, love that. Okay, cool. Oh, I was going to say, a coach said to me, she said to me, I'm more obsessed with freedom than I am with perfection. Do you love that? I loved that. I'm more obsessed with freedom. Like, what are you more obsessed with? Are you more obsessed with like feeling relaxed or feeling ease and comfort? And like, what are you more obsessed with than perfection? Because I think that's also a good thing to kind of like give yourself that like baseline, I guess. But perfectionism, ditch it. I love that. Okay, Laura. Hi, Laura. I'm glad you're joining us. I'm done feeling like I'm not good enough. Ooh, that's a good one. I'm done with that too. Because here's the deal. You are good enough. Like, you're totally good enough. If you're on this live stream, if you're watching, you are enough. You are smart. You're bright. Like, women that are attracted to me, that like wanna interact with me, they are cool freaking women. And they are totally enough. You're totally enough, Laura. I love that. I bet there's a lot of other women that are feeling the same way. Hi, Shannon. Hi, Patty. Oh, cool. Hi, guys. I'm catching up here. Okay, yes, self-doubt, Ellen says. I love that. Shannon. So Shannon's ready to give up looking at other vendors and trucks and thinking I need to carry what they have too. Ooh, that's like really boutique specific, but I love that. So yeah, and you know what, Shannon? That's a lot about thinking about who your ideal customer is, right? Like, you serve someone very different than probably those other trucks or vendors do. So at the end of the day, like, you, if you know your ideal customer, you know your ideal client, like, you don't have to worry, right? Because you know, like, I always knew when someone walks into my truck, I'd be like, oh, that's my ideal customer. I knew who she was, right? So yeah, let's be done. That's totally comparing ourselves to you. Hi, Patty. I love you, Patty. Thank you. You're beautiful. Thank you. I love helping people too. It's definitely my passion. My passion has become helping women, especially women. I love men too, but I love women. Okay, Clydeen, I like that. We're not, no, oh my God, we're totally not meant to be perfectionists, right? That's like some societal crap that like, I don't know where that even came from, but we're totally humans. Oh my God, please. Like, look at our human bodies. Like, we're not perfect. Like, our faces aren't symmetrical. Like, you know, totally. This is not a thing. Okay, Cherry. Hi, Cherry. I love your name, Cherry. It's so fun. I'm done feeling inferior. Ooh. You guys, these are really good things. I like it. So, okay, does anyone else have anything else they want to declare that they're done with? And this is, here's the thing, guys. I filled an entire sheet of paper with things I was done with. An entire sheet. Because here's the thing, I like made myself some tea and I just was like on a roll. Like, I was like, and I filled up a whole sheet of paper. And I think when you start to think of like, wow, like there's so many things, like we've just like cracked, we've kind of cracked the core here, right? We've cracked like what's top of mind. But when you sit and you're quiet and you really get like intimate with what's going on in your head and what's in your body, and you start to let that go on paper, like, I know the physicalness of it was so helpful for me. Like, writing all this down and just being like, wow, like, I came up with things that I didn't even totally like realize were holding me back, right? And I think this is, for me, one of the reasons Patty said, I look so happy. Yeah, one of the reasons I look so happy is this is something I did 2 days ago that once I let it go, I burned it in the fire. And then I went to acupuncture and I went to yoga and I let it all go. I set the intention that all this crap that I wrote down, all this negative, all this junk, I'm going to let go of. And that's really the first step in being able to hit your big goals. Because when you have big goals and you're still playing down here and you're still holding yourself back and you're like, you know, you're keeping everything kind of locked in really tight, you're not able to be open. You're not able to share whatever you're doing with the world. Even if it's just sharing like in your office, maybe you work in an office and, you know, maybe the weight of other people or the weight of the business is like weighing you down. Like, even if that's the only thing, like, fine, like, let's let that go. Let's leave that in 2016. Let's leave that in the past, in the past, right? We don't need to hold on to that, because when we hold so tight and we grip so tight, it's just, it physically builds up, right? Like, I have a lot of shoulder tension, and that's something I work on because I hold all my stress here, right? Maybe you can relate. Maybe you hold your stress in your hips or in your stomach, or, you know, when we let go of all this crap, mind and body is all related, right? So we start to let go, we can start to really move to the next level, right? We have to let go before we can bring in new stuff. I remember there was a woman, she always said to me, you have to clear the clutter before you can be creative. And I love that. I love it. You have to clear the clutter. And I think this to me is like clearing the clutter out of your mind. Clearing the clutter out of, you don't need to go clean your house. If you want to, great. I love that. But let's clear the clutter out of our minds. I'm just going to check in some. Ellen says she's done focusing on negatives and she's going to focus on positives. Yeah. So let me tell you, oh, we have another negative comment. I'm done with negative people. I realize that you can't always be happy and positive. We all have those moments when I find it draining when someone is always negative. Ooh, yeah. So let me tell you a few things about that. Number one, people who are negative all the time, I'm going to let you in on a secret. People who are negative all the time are probably in a lot of pain. They're probably suffering. They're probably not able to look at what's going on in their life in the way we just did and put down what's going on and let it go. There's something inside holding them back. So the way I learned to look at negative people is to say, you know what? There's something going on with them, and I'm going to just send them love. I'm going to send that negative person love. I'm going to say, I hope whatever's going on with them, whether they realize it or not, I'm going to pray for them, and I'm going to hope that everything goes well and that they can turn things around, right? The second piece of that, like dealing with negativity and negative people, the second piece of that is really, if you've ever studied law of attraction, lost me. Hi, am I still here? I think I'm still live. Let's see. You still here? Everyone's still here? Can I get some hearts if you can hear me and you can see me? Can I just get a few hearts? Hi. Hi, hi, hi. Couldn't agree more. Sending love. Hi, Brittany. Yes, sending love. I always send love to people who I see. Okay, I'm back. Great. I'm still here. Okay, thanks, guys. Thanks. Cool. Okay, good. Checking in. Great. So people who are negative, who feel like they're depressed, who feel down, who have that kind of negative like aura or energy, whatever you want to call it, those people might be in a lot of pain and suffering. And it might not be something we can see physically on the outside. So I want you to be really sensitive. I mean, it takes a lot, trust me. I've had to definitely realize that people who are negative, you know, number one, they're in a lot of pain. Number two, one of the reasons I tend to attract a lot of positive people or attract a lot of women who have a positive outlook or want to have a more positive outlook is because I myself like stay in a high vibration all the time. So two things is, one, we attract what we put out. It's just law of attraction. If you've ever seen The Secret, if you've ever read any Abraham Hicks or Jack Canfield or any books like that, Mike Dooley, these are all books that I can put in the comments after. But we attract what we put out. It's called law of attraction, right? Have you ever seen someone who says, oh, I'm so unlucky. Like, I'm the most unlucky person. And guess what? Like, bad stuff happens to them, right? Like, they don't have a lot. You love The Secret. Okay, so think about The Secret. The Secret talks all about how we attract what we put out. So if we keep putting out negativity, then that's what's going to come back to us. So Ellen, I think it's so great you declared earlier that you're going to give up the negative and focus on the positive. And let me tell you, when you decide to do that and you decide to focus on good things and what's good going on in your life, then more good things will happen. I even say sometimes when I'm feeling like, oh, things are feeling a little rocky, I'll actually spend a whole day writing down, I have like 1,000 notebooks. So in one of my notebooks, I'll spend the whole day writing down everything that's going well that day. Even if it's just like, oh, I made a really great cup of tea for myself. Even if it's, I bought Greg coffee or I bought Greg lunch today. When you start to think about the positive things, the momentum builds, right? So if you ever feel like you're having a negative moment or a negative day, the quickest way to turn it around is to start seeing the good. Start seeing what did go well. You found a great parking space, or something you ordered from Amazon showed up at your front door, or it can be as little things, right? Like someone smiled at you in Starbucks or something, right? So that's the quickest way to start being more positive. So I think it's really good that everyone's wanting to be more positive. I think that's a really good thing because positivity is what breeds more positivity, right? So step one, we've talked about this for a while. I'm so excited. I love this workshop, How to Get to Your Big Goals. If you are here, if you're loving it, please give me some hearts. I'm staring at myself on the screen and sometimes I'm like, are people there? So give me some hearts. Say hi if you're just joining. Step number one, just to quickly review, is to let go of whatever's holding you back. So decide what you're going to declare that you're done with and let it go. And if you want to go so far as to rip this piece of paper up, you want to throw it in a fire, you want to shred it, you want to burn it, like whatever you need to do to truly let go of all this stuff, energetically, mentally, you know. And here's the thing, some of this stuff might still come up, right? This might be a great activity you want to do once a month or once a week. Like, what's coming up for you? Let's let it go, right? We hold on to things. I want to start using positivity jar. Oh, that's fun. I like that, Claudine. So Claudine's going to start using I've seen this on Pinterest too. You put little positive thoughts in it and then you read them on New Year's Eve. I love that. So positive things that happened all year. I love that. That's so fun. I kind of do the same when I write my goals out. You know, I'll look back. One of the things I did this past couple weeks is I look back on like, what did I do this year? And I had done so much cool stuff. That's why I'm teaching this class, right? Because I want you to know that you can have whatever you want. You can get whatever you want. You can be whoever you want. My goals for this year are drastically different than my goals from last year because it's kind of like that momentum thing I'm talking about, right? So you can move as fast as you want through your goals, but you kind of have to hit those touch points too, right? So let's move on to step number two. Who's ready for number two? Give me some hearts if you're ready for step number two. Okay, this workshop is really fun. Do we love this live stream format? I was like, oh, I'm going to make people sign up for it, but you know what? It's New Year's Day, or it's not New Year's Day. It's New Year's Eve day, and so I just wanted you guys to be able to casually jump on and off. I'm going to leave the replay up, so if you'd like to watch this later, you can watch it again, and if you don't have all the supplies that I've been busting out, you can go get the supplies and do this again. Okay, so step number two is, what are your goals? Like, let's start to think about what are some of the goals. Sorry for the ruffling. What are some of the goals that you want? And again, I put my big piece of paper out. Because here's the deal, guys. The bigger we can see our goals, that's why I love this big, like, I'll show you guys again if you missed it earlier. I love big pieces of paper. I can map out so much of my life. This is my business. I'm going to map out my life tonight and tomorrow. Hi, Terry. Everyone. No, I don't think everyone here is boutique owners. I think some are. Of course, I attract boutique owners because that's who I coach. So if you don't know me, you're new to me. I'm Emily Benson. I'm a best-selling author of The Ultimate Boutique Handbook. And my boutique, The Fashion Truck, has been featured in Forbes and InStyle. I no longer have the truck, and now I've devoted my life to coaching and consulting women who own boutiques, and I coach women who have other businesses too. But my main focus is boutiques, retail, and product-based entrepreneurs. So welcome, hi, Today we're not really talking about boutiques, but this stuff obviously does apply, right? I think that one of the reasons I have, oh cool, direct sales, 31, yes. So yeah, see, this is great. You sell products too. I love 31. So, what am I thinking about? So, all of this can be applied. I don't care who you are, even if you don't have a business. You can do all this, right? This is good stuff. I have one of my very best friends. She works in advertising for a great magazine, and I've turned her on to a lot of this stuff because she was feeling like, wow, I would love to do more personal development work. I'd love to keep growing. You know, one of the things that happens in our lives is that we get older and we leave school and we think that we're done, but we're not. We have so much more time. You guys, we are going to live until we're like 100, and it's going to get very boring if we don't keep learning and don't keep doing more things and challenging ourselves. So no matter what age you are, you can always learn more. I've learned more in the past like 2 years than I think I learned in the five before that. And the five before that is when I really started my business and my entrepreneurial journey. So there is so much more for you to learn. There's so much more for me to learn, all of us. So let's move on to step number two. So let's talk about it. What are your goals? And I'm going to guess that when I ask you that, maybe your first thought was, I want X, but that's too much. Or I want to do Y, but that feels like I maybe can't do it. So we just gave up some self-doubt, right? We just gave up worry. We just gave up some junky junk from 2016. So what I want to challenge you to do for your goals for this year is make them, how do I say this? I want them to be realistic and I want them to be achievable, but I also want them to be kind of a stretch. I want them to make you feel a little bit uncomfortable. And this is where I might lose some people. Hey, Anne. Oh, I'm so glad to see you, Anne. Hi. I'm going to adjust my pillows here. I'm sitting on the floor. I love sitting on the floor. It's like one of my favorite things. I like sitting on the floor because I can stay grounded. So when we talk about goals, now here's the time where I want you to stretch. I want you to stretch. Hi, Janelle. I want you to stretch with your goals, okay? I want you to think, who loves this shirt? I love this shirt. I feel like an angel in it. So I want you to stretch with your goals. I want you to think, what do I want to do? And does it scare me a little bit? Yes! Happy New Year! I'm psyched for 2017. Janelle, you're on my list of people to email this week too. So does it scare you a little bit? Like this year, we moved out of our apartment. We traveled all around the country. We traveled around the world too, to be honest. And scared me a lot. Like it was not easy for me. However, did I grow? Did I have a blast? Did I change? Did I become a better person, a more cultured person, a more open to new things person? Yes. So you can do this two ways, right? I tend to do this. Sorry for my mic. Okay. So you can do this two ways. I've done this kind of both ways. I've done this as goals for my business, and I've done this as goals for my life. So my life stuff, I'm going to be doing tonight and tomorrow. I did my business stuff the other day, but you could also do this holistically, right? So last year I did this holistically and I can't reach my big goals. I had a huge goals list like a year and a half ago. It's a little bit too big, to be honest. Some of the stuff on there, I was like, oh wow, I don't know if I can do this in 1 year. Like, it's actually like not realistic. So like I said, I want it to be a little bit realistic, also a little bit of a stretch, right? One of the things that was on my goals list was to go to Paris, did that. We went to Guatemala, we went to LA. Those were all on my goals list. So And then there were new things that popped up too. So I want you to start to think about what are some goals that you can reach. So what kind of goals would be good? Well, first would be, how do you want to feel this year? So we just let go of a lot of junk. We let go of maybe feeling overwhelmed, feeling too busy, feeling self-doubt. So maybe we want to make some of these goals around how we want to feel. So we want to feel confident this year. We want to feel excited. We want to feel passionate about our relationship. We want to feel, and I'm just throwing out ideas, right? This can be totally something that maybe you have to take offline. Maybe you're just jotting down some notes right now, and you want to take offline and really sit and reflect, right? So what are some things, how do you want to feel? And then transfer that into how you can do that. So maybe you want to feel like you have more time to do what you need to do. So, because that's going to help you feel less overwhelmed. So an example of what you would do to do that is, number one, you would stop saying you're so busy, right? That's something you can very quickly and easily do. Stop saying, oh, I'm so overwhelmed. Oh, and I can never get anything done. You know, sometimes our words are more powerful than we realize. And then the second thing is, maybe you need to actually give yourself more time to do what you need to do, right? Maybe it's not achievable to like do 8 things in a day. Maybe your to-do list needs to be 2 things in a day, right? So there's a little bit of what I like to call mindset involved, and there's a little bit of actual physical activity involved in some of these goals. And they can all relate back to how you want to feel, right? All go back to how you want to feel. One of my biggest things is I want to feel calm. Calm, right? I feel like excited a lot. I feel like, I have so many ideas. I want to do so much, right? And one of my desired feelings is to feel a little bit more calm and more centered and more grounded. That's why I said, I sit on the floor sometimes, right? Because I want to feel like, whoa, there's the ground, Emily. Like, stay on the ground a little bit, right? Because I am the type of person where I'm super creative. And maybe you can relate. If you can relate, like, give me some hearts. Maybe you're super creative and you feel like, well, I can do this and I can do this and I can do that and blah, 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 blah. And then suddenly you're like doing 10 things and none of them are really getting finished. Some of them are like really not things you need to be doing. Like creative women are so cool. But we also can get so distracted and so overwhelmed, right? So this is why one of my desired feelings is to feel calm. Because when I know when I feel calm, that's when I feel like I can organize my thoughts and I can look at things with the perspective that I need to actually complete and follow through and actually think, like, is this something I need to be doing, right? Okay, Claudine says she has so many ideas. Sometimes they lead to inactivity because you can't decide where to start. Right, totally, absolutely. And the brilliant thing about being creative is that you'll never be done with the ideas, right? This year I learned one thing that Tony Robbins talks about a lot is he says that you should write down 3 ideas every morning, 3 new ideas. And be okay with letting those ideas go. Some of those ideas aren't going to be great ideas, but at least you're getting them out. You're like getting the idea out. You're writing it down. And keep a notebook of that. Maybe someday down the line that will be an idea. So how do you want to feel? And then how are you going to get to those goals? Kind of mixing those up, meshing those together. So I want to feel calm. And one of my goals is to write another book, right? That's for me, that's personally, I plan to write another book in the first quarter of this year. I actually want to write 2 books this year. So what do I need to do to feel calm and centered to write that book and be able to get it done? There's certain things I need to put into place. I need to have a really good routine. I need to sleep really well. I need to have a schedule. I'm very scheduled. If you know me, if you're one of my clients, you know I have a schedule, a very tight schedule. But that schedule allows for relaxation. That schedule allows time for fun. But if it's not on my schedule, it doesn't happen. So I tend to schedule everything, which is actually good for me because, again, as being a creative person, if I don't have that schedule, I'm just like running around chicken with my head cut off, right? So what do you need to do? What are your goals? What are like a top 4 or 5 goals you want to achieve this year? This is not going to get all done in January. You know this, what I showed you guys this? This is my big chart. This is my year, okay? This is my whole year, okay? And it ripped a little at the top, so I'm kind of sad. This is my whole year. Legit. I am not trying to do all this stuff tomorrow. I've done that. I've tried to do all this stuff in one day. It doesn't work. It doesn't work for me. So that's my whole year. So once I can start to map it out and see what do I want to do, how do I want to feel, then I can start to say, okay, this is going to be done in April. This is going to be done in July. This is going to be done in February, right? So a lot of this stuff, to be very honest with you, it might be all done by August. And maybe I need to do this again. However, I've mapped out what feels realistic and also feels like a stretch. So like, let's say one of my goals for this year. So let's do this. I would love if you're here, I want you to declare one of your goals in the comments below. Tell me one of your goals. What do you want to achieve this year? Whether it be financial, whether it be how you want to feel, whether it's maybe it's something around family. You want to spend more time with family. Maybe you want to travel. Maybe there's somewhere special you want to go. Tell me what it is. I'm going to share with you right now too. I'm going to share one thing. And this scares me. I'll be honest. This scares me. I want to have, and I'm looking at my sheet. I want to have 4 speaking gigs, like on stage with audiences of 500 or more this year. That kind of scares me, guys. 500 people. But that's one of my goals. I want to have 4 speaking gigs. And now you all know, I've declared it to the world. I want 4 speaking gigs to be on stage for like a 30 to 45 minute talk on stage with 500 people. Nancy, you're here. Hi. Okay, let's see. Here we go. And I want my website to go crazy. I love that. Nancy wants to use technology to provide a group class. I love that. That is definitely a stretch for you, Nancy. Azor Day? Am I saying that right? I'm sorry if I'm not. It's a gorgeous name though. To be the top real estate agent in my office. Yes, girl. And to triple my profits on my fashion truck. Amazing. Wow. Those are 2 really big goals. I love that. Clydene. To be more consistent in my social media posts, Facebook and Instagram. Okay, Clydene. Nancy, you can so do this. Hey, oh my God, Nancy and Clydene. I love this. So Clydene, I know you want to be more consistent. Do you have another bigger stretch goal? Sorry, Nancy knows me. I challenge people. Clydene, give me something else. Give me another, like something that scares you a little bit. Because being consistent, that's totally a goal, and I'm not trying to be negative. I don't want that to be, I want you to have something that scares you a little bit. Like maybe, so you do direct sales for 31. So maybe you want to recruit, like maybe your goal for the year is to recruit 5 new consultants, right? Maybe it's, you want to do like double the amount of parties you did last year or something like that. I love 31. Hi, Nancy. So I love these. Azure Day. Wow. Top real estate agent and to do double your profits. So that's totally scary. And I love that it's scary. So now that we have these goals, website to go crazy. Okay, so now that we have these goals, right? We have these kind of like these big goals. What's the next step in defining that? So I'll show you here. I was going to do this all mapped out on paper, but I'm not like having fun with my tripod. So let's look at this. So now we can take this and map it out. So let's look at what maybe a chunk of this looks like for me, right? So I have group coaching. I'm still going to provide group coaching, right? And it's going to be my six-figure blueprint program that I'm running now. Actually, if you're on here and you've been thinking about signing up, tonight is the deadline, guys, for the last round. I'm not doing it in the same way after this. So it's going to be a little different. And I know because I planned it out, right? It's going to become a different model. And I'm going to make it a little bit more... it's going to be a little bit easier for me to run it because right now it's a little bit of work. And I want to focus more, like I said, this year for me is about speaking and writing. Those are like kind of my new things that I want to add. And part of speaking is speaking on stage. I want to add a podcast, right? Like these things all scare the shit out of me. So what does that look like for you? As Jordy. Amazing. Okay. It's scary if you feel like, oh, Clydeen, I give you some ideas. LOL. But my next goal business-wise is to reach out to 3 to 5 people a week about my business. Awesome. Okay, I love that. That I like that. It is scary to think about posts. But here's the deal. So, Clydeen, one of the things you could do is... So right in the middle of my map here, oh God, guys, it's so loud, sorry. In the middle is my business name, right? Stylish and Successful. So this could be 31, right? Your 31 business. And you could come off of this, right? And again, guys, this can be your life too. This can be Emily's life. I'm going to do this for my life. Emily's life. And it's going to be like relationship, family, travel. It's going to be different for my life. You see how it's a little bit different? This is my business. So passive income, membership site, group coaching, one-on-one. So for you, Clydeen, yours could be, you know, recruiting. What does recruiting look like? What is social media? What does that look like for you? And then underneath, guys, all I did is I wrote little bullet points of what I wanted to do that, right? So I have like the name. Okay, my membership site. I'm going to launch that in February. It's going to be called the Stylish Success Membership. 12 months of boutique specific trainings, access to my boutique resources, 12 months of guest experts. I'm going to do a little book club in it, I think, and it's going to be $29 a month, and my goal is to have 300 members by the end of the year, right? So do you see how I kind of like, my arm's getting tired. Do you see how I like kind of, I have that big top line goal of like, okay, I want to do this membership site, and I'm listing out like, what does it look like in terms of, I've got to get this mic thing right. I love this mic, but like the hair, the mic. So I want to do the membership site, right? That's kind of like my top line goal. So as Jordy. So for you as Jordy, right, to be the top real estate agent, that would be one box. What does that look like? What do you need to do to be the top agent? So maybe underneath it, it's, you know, I don't totally understand real estate that much, but maybe some bullet points of how you're going to get there. And then what does that look like dollar-wise too, right? So I want to have, you know, 12 sales this year all over $500,000, right? Homes, something like that. What does that actually look like? So you can give yourself a sort of scope of what the goal is. So you have your top line goal and then you're working it down. So this is step number two. I need an updo. I do, but I love my hair down. as long as it's not too scruffy, great goals. I feel like when you write them down, it becomes reality. Yes, thank you, Janelle. That is That is part of this, is writing things down. And that actually transitions really well into number three. So number one we talked about was writing down and getting rid of anything that doesn't serve you. So junk it, scrap it, throw it in the fire, right? We're going to ditch anything that's not serving us. Number two is we're going to start to define our goals. Like what are the big goals for 2017? And we're going to, and guys, I hate resolutions. Like this is not a talk about resolutions. I think resolutions are really stupid because no one does them, right? But I'm going to show you now that we have our big goals, let's talk about how we're going to implement them during the year. Let me take a sip. Hi Deb, how are you? Oh my gosh, all my favorite peeps are on here. I love it. Okay, so what is step number three? So we let go, we wrote down our big goals, we put some metrics to our big goals, and we put some plan of action in our big goals. The next step is how do we carry this through the year, right? Because this has always been, I think, right? We talked about humans not being perfect. I think this is where we become our imperfection show, is because we get so excited in the beginning of the year and then we lose momentum. We're like, oh, well, this is hard, right? And if you watch The Secret, you know, it's ask, believe, receive. So we're asking the universe, we're declaring to the universe what we're getting rid of. We're declaring what we want. Next is believing. And part of why New Year's resolutions, I think, don't work is because people don't really believe they can happen. Because guess what? You can't lose 15 pounds in 2 weeks. So by mid-January, you haven't lost your 15 pounds. Like, you're not really believing in that, right? Maybe it's going to take you a little longer. So part of writing down our goals is also saying to ourselves, and saying to ourselves in the universe, that it's not all going to happen tomorrow. It's not all going to happen in January. And we're okay with that. Because frankly, we need something to do the rest of the year. We need other goals for the rest of the year. So for me, right, last year I wrote down, like, we wanted to go to LA. We wanted to be in sunny places. Sometimes your goals can also be like a little bit more discreet. They don't have to be as super, super defined, and you don't have to worry about the how's it gonna happen, right? Like we decided to travel and we didn't really worry about how we were gonna do it. We were just like, okay, where are we gonna go? How do we wanna feel? We put some parameters around where we wanted to be, and then we ended up in those places. You know, I have La Jolla, California as a screensaver to my computer. And we ended up this fall in La Jolla, California. So things like that, we can talk magic later, but let's like stay here. Janelle, I'm not a resolution person either. Good. I choose one word each year for my number one goal, and it helps me decide on all the little goals from there. For 2016, it was joy. 2017, it's fearless. Oh, what a switch. I love that. I love that. You guys, Janelle is an amazing, amazing public relations professional. I think that's the best way to describe it. And she's been doing amazing live streams. I love watching her. And Janelle, fearless is an awesome word. And I love joy. So joy. Janelle and I met in a bathroom at a conference because she was wearing, and Deb, if you're still here, you'll love this. Janelle was wearing Kelly Green high heels. And I was like, girl, like, look at you. I was like, what are those shoes? Because you guys know me. I love fashion. And it was such a great way to connect. So I love that, Janelle. I think picking a word, picking that, like we talked about earlier, that core desired feeling, right? Your core desired feeling was joy. So everything you did was based around what's going to bring me more joy. What's going to bring the joy, right? Oh my God, that's totally a Brendan thing too. Brendan Burchard, bring the joy. So how do you want to feel? So third is like, how do we actually start to do this in our daily life? How do we start to do this in a weekly situation? One of the things I've really been clear about in my life is having a routine that keeps me in a high vibration. And a lot of that is self-care. A lot of us don't take good care of ourselves because we feel like other things are more important. Our business, our kids, our husbands, our spouses, our house, whatever it is, we just don't take good care of ourselves. And self-care for women is, like, I think, one of the most important things. If we don't have a routine, if we don't have those times where we get to reflect, then it's really hard to achieve our goals. And so one of the things I do every day, and here's the deal, guys. I don't wake up at 5 in the morning, okay? I'm not, like, a miracle morning person. I'm not doing that. That's just not me. You have to find what works for you, okay? What works for me is I do a meditation in the morning. Before I even get out of bed, I just pop my headphones in. I listen. I chill. I kind of let go of whatever happened in my dreams overnight. I let that go, and then I can start my day fresh. You know, I eat the same breakfast every morning. I have gotten into a place where I have certain key YouTube videos, certain key subliminal messaging things that I, you know, positive confident, what are they called? Positive self-talk, recordings, certain things like that, that will keep me high vibration in the morning so that I can stay that way all day, right? If we don't start our morning off in a high vibration, it's going to be really hard. Well, it's going to be a little harder to get back there. Right? So I try to start my day off in the best way possible. So what does that look like for you? What does that look like? One of the other things I do after I do my meditation is I'm grabbing my notebook of the day, my notebook of the moment, because I have multiple of them. And guys, I actually kind of started what I want to do. So I love these big pieces of paper. So like, I want to get my first book in print, right? I want to go to Paris. I want to visit my best friends. I want to go back to San Francisco. There's certain things, like, I love drawing. So this has been one of the things that's been really good for me. Affirmations. Affirmations. Yeah, I love affirmations. But the thing with affirmations is that you have to believe them. That's the tough part. So affirmations don't work for everyone. I think it's hard because I think you have to find the right ones, right? You have to find the things that work for you. So after I do my meditation in the morning, I then sit up and I take what I would call my notebook of the month, and I write out my goals. So I've chunked out whatever the goals are. The big goals, I've chunked them out by month, right? I like looking at it by month. It's a little bit easier. So as you can see, most of this notebook is just me writing my goals. And some of them are, you know, I throw some ideas in here too, because sometimes ideas pop up. But these are my every single day this month, me writing my goals. And part of that is staying focused on your goals, right? Even if you just pick one goal for the month, one goal, that one goal, if you write that down every morning and every night, you're seeing it, you're feeling it, even if you say it out loud, right? That is going to make a huge difference in actually achieving that goal, because you're constantly asking the universe to enforce that goal. Nancy, you love the idea of the notebook of the month. I have too many going at once. I sometimes do too, Nancy. I think it's like the new notebook syndrome. But one notebook a month, I really like. And then I tend to have like probably three notebooks going at once, because I have one notebook that I just use to keep my client notes. And then I have one notebook that is kind of with my big ideas for the month, where I like will write outlines for, you know, like I want to write two books. Like, I kind of already have somewhat of outlines for both of them going in another notebook. And then I have my goals notebook. So I have like a very specific goals notebook, and I write those goals down every day in the morning, sometimes at night. depends on how tired I am. But I try to do them at night as well. So putting those two things into place, just the meditation, just the goals, writing them down, focusing on them, that's how you can sustain. And once that routine becomes a habit, then you're just doing it. And then each month you're like, oh, it's a new month. Let me switch out my goals, right? And maybe when you write down your goals, you say, well, I need support with this, or I need to figure out X, Y, and Z to be able to get to that goal. You know, when we see our goals every day, it starts to trigger certain things. So like even when I was at acupuncture yesterday, I was laying there and suddenly, you know, acupuncture is supposed to relax you. Normally I fall asleep. Yesterday I like couldn't fall asleep, but I was super relaxed and I had like this amazing idea for a new webinar that I want to do. And I was like, okay, I'm going to do this and this. And it wasn't even like I was thinking about it. It just came to me. So the more you focus on your goals, but also kind of for me, like is chilling out a little bit and not gripping so tightly on those goals, it allows a lot of spaciousness to be able to come up with new ideas and not have to worry so much about how am I going to do this? Right? It's when we start to worry about the hows that kind of get us stuck. So I see some people commenting. Let me read these. Nancy, cool. Hi, Melinda. How are you? Welcome. Oh my gosh, I'm obsessed with notebooks and journals. Me too. I think it's all about like finishing the notebooks though. I love when I finish it because I'm like, ooh, I like stuck with this notebook, right? What do you guys have trouble with in terms of and here's a place, great time to ask any questions as we're starting to kind of finish up here. What questions do you have for me? Like what do you struggle with most during the year? Staying on point, staying on task, and really like getting these goals done. Because I know for me, it's definitely taken work. It's taken working with a coach. It's taken putting this routine into place. It's taken refocusing. Right? Learning. This year was a big learning year for me. Big swings. Clydine, I lost the audio for a couple of minutes. Are you writing the same goals every day to reinforce them? Are you adding new goals? I'm writing the same goals every day for 1 month. 1 month. I'm picking a goal. I'm picking like 3 or 4 goals for a month and I'm sticking with them. Writing them in the morning, writing them in the afternoon or night before I go to bed, planting them. I literally buy one new one every time I go to Home Goods. Well, girl, I like that. Are you using them, Melinda? What are you using your notebooks for? Are they helping you hit your goals? Sorry, I have to readjust. I think we've been here for a while. Okay. Focus. Cherry, it's hard for you to focus. So, Cherry, I would say to you, it's hard for you to focus. So let me give you some tips. One is put things on a calendar. I have my G calendar that I use and I break things down so that they're easy for me to accomplish and then I can stay focused. So what does that focus look like for me? So as I go into the new year and I start to focus on, like, one of my big focuses will be writing my second book. So what that means is that I'm going to set aside probably about an hour or two or three days a week, and that will be my writing hour. A lot of my books are already kind of written in certain ways. But those 2 or 3 hours, what I will do is I will get rid of every other tab. I will turn my phone on Do Not Disturb. I'll probably totally turn my phone off. I'll throw in my headphones and I'll focus on that one thing. You know, one of the things that women are really good at that we were born with this brilliant ability to do is to multitask, right? Multitask. Oh, we got to multitask. Multitask is killing your focus, most likely. Okay. So, oh my gosh, we're all talking about notebooks. I love it. We're all loving notebooks. I have so many notebooks too. So ban yourself from doing anything else that's, what is that one thing on your calendar? That has been something huge that's helped me focus and that's really helped me accomplish these goals, right? Because when we don't, it's awesome to have these big goals, but if we don't focus on them, we can't get to them, right? So what's it going to take for you to focus? Does it mean that you need to, so let me give you a couple more examples. I had a client who, she actually had 6 kids and she started her business in 3 months. She's kind of like Superwoman. But one of the things she had to do to focus, because what we found out in some of our sessions was she'd say to me, she'd be like, Emily, I'm just doing things all day, but I'm not really getting things done. And I'm like, whoa, like, why are you doing things all day? Like, how can you feel like you're accomplishing anything? And she didn't. So what she did is she actually decided to hire a nanny to come 2 days a week for like 3 or 4 hours during those 2 days. And she would leave and go to, she had to leave her house. Like, she couldn't stay in her office in her house. She had to leave her house. She found a great coffee shop, or she'd go to the library. And she would just go and she'd have her list of things that she needed to accomplish during that time. And those were, like, she just worked down the list. So she felt like she got things done. She felt like she could focus. And it made her move quicker. Like, it made her move much more quickly. So I think you have to find out what's going to help you focus best. Is it going to be putting things on the calendar? Is it going to be turning off your phone? Like, I have to turn off my phone. I turned off all my Facebook alerts. I don't get alerts from Facebook. I don't get alerts from Instagram. I don't get alerts anymore. And it's awesome because I get to choose when I go on Facebook and answer questions from you guys. I get to choose when I go on Instagram and post something new, right? And I don't spend time on there. We've become the society of, like, freaking distractions everywhere. So stop being distracted. Make the choice that you'll stop being distracted, that you'll stay focused. And through this whole process, I'm trying to help you focus through this process. So now it's up to you to put into, like, what's going to work on a daily and weekly basis for you to be able to focus, like, in that day, in that hour, all that kind of stuff, right? So let me just scroll. Hopefully that's helpful. Focus. Janelle, how did I take the steps to launch my online course? Ooh, good question. How did I take the steps? Well, number one is I gave myself enough time to do it. I had the idea in August and I gave myself a whole 6 weeks to get it up and launched. And I actually, what I did is before I even did, like, wrote the material for the course, I wrote the outline. I thought, like, what do I want the results to be from this course? I wrote the outline. And then once I wrote the outline and said, okay, here's the features, the benefits, what you're going to get out of it, then I actually went and before the first week, I started actually doing the workbooks and writing the material to go into the course. So I kind of, like, I'm a big fan of, like, almost pre-selling stuff and then creating it. Because I know women need it. I know women need what I sell. But it's also kind of getting women on board to invest in themselves and believe that what I can give them is going to be helpful, right? So the steps that I took, hopefully, is that... So I had the idea, and actually I took one of my big pieces. I have easel paper for days. I just ran out, actually. During this webinar, I ran out of easel paper, so I need to go to Target and get some more easel paper. But the easel paper, I put it out on the bar, and I just was like, okay, this is who I want to speak to. This is what I want to teach them. This is what I want them to get out of it. And this is how I'm gonna. These are, like, the units, right? Like, units, chapters of a book. And I had a friend actually say, her dad said to her, what are the 10 most important things you want to teach someone? And those are, like, the 10 chapters of your book. Those are the 10 weeks of your course with an intro and an outro, right? So think about maybe it's the 8 most important things, right? How long do you want your course to be? What I learned after running it first round was I gave way too much information for 8 weeks. And it was like almost too much because I have so much in this damn brain that I know. And so I extended it to 12 weeks. So now I'm like giving people smaller chunks so they can do it along the way. The other thing I did to launch my course was I made sure that I had, you know, I just hosted on my Squarespace site, on my back end of my Squarespace site. I used MailChimp to set up, you know, I sent emails out a couple times a week to the people who signed up. And I really just marketed it to my email list. I probably could probably do a better job marketing what I sell. That's one of my big kind of focuses this year is building my email list and making sure that you guys all know what the hell I do and what the hell I'm selling. Because I think sometimes I know and like a few people know, but it's I got to tell more people all the time. So that was something I kind of looking back, like I wish I had done. I still think I need to improve on launching in terms of my online course. Good. Good, Melinda. I like that you're using your notebooks. Shannon loves her notebooks. Melinda, so funny. Clydean, multitasking just means you have many things in different states of undone. Yeah, kind of. Multitasking is going to be the death of a person's business if they don't rein it in, to be honest. Like most of the clients I work with are trying to do 87 things at once. And it's cool. Like, I love that they're so creative, but it's really hard to build a business. So it's easy to start a business, right? Anyone can start a business. It's easy. It's really hard to grow a business. And to grow a business, you can't be a multitasker all the time. Maybe some days you can, but not all the time. You have to take things step by step by step. And what I've found is that a lot of times when women have their to-do list, there's like eight things, like it'll be like, I need to launch an online course. Let's use that example. I need to launch an online course. And for each part of launching the online course, there's like eight to-dos. And like we're trying to do all that at once and it just doesn't work. So multitasking is no bueno. Okay, Cherry. Thanks very much for all the good tips. I am alone in the business. Yeah, a lot of us are alone in our business. It's hard. That's why, you know what, Cherry? That's why I have my Fashion Chick Tribe group. That's why I have my I Do What I Want entrepreneur group. A lot of women-owned businesses are solo-owned businesses, like solopreneurs or whatever. So I would highly suggest if you're feeling lonely or you're feeling like, you know, you don't have the support, there's a couple things you can do. And I know this comes up a lot for like all my clients, this comes up. And I know this was something I struggled with too. I don't think I realized I struggled with it until it was a little bit too late for me. I think I kind of got in a place where I was like really not, like I was super alone. And that doesn't mean like I didn't have family and friends and a great boyfriend. Like I had support, you know, but I think one of the reasons I'm doing what I am doing now in being a coach and being a consultant is helping women not be alone and showing them that, you know, having support, having someone to come to in your business who has been there before, who is up-leveling constantly and helping, you know, I'm helping myself all the time learn new things. Then that helps me lift my clients up. That helps me lift anyone in my group up, right? So don't be alone. Choose not to be alone. Choose to be active in Facebook groups. You know, you can be super active in my Fashion Chick Tribe group and say, hey, I'm feeling lonely today. Like, who else is feeling lonely? You know, what are you guys working on? Like, let's connect. The other thing you can do is you can find a mastermind partner. And that's something I've done. I have a couple mastermind partners. And those are people who are kind of at my level where I feel like we're kind of on the same pace with each other, if that makes sense. Like we're at the same level of our business. And we talk every week or every other week. And we kind of laser coach each other. You know, it's not like a bitch session. It's not like a vent session. It's a, hey, what do you need help with? And how can I brainstorm with you? right? How can I help you? How can you help me? It's mutually beneficial. And it's free. Like, it's free. We don't, like, pay each other. We just, you know, we do it because we really like each other. And we do it because we have different perspectives on our businesses, even though we both, you know, the women that are my mastermind partners are also, you know, service-based coach consultants. So I think it's important for you to find someone who kind of does something similar to what you do, but that can provide a different perspective, right? So mastermind partners are amazeballs. Get some mastermind partners and schedule time to talk with them every week or every other week. That's a great resource too. So how to not feel alone. And I'm like on this tangent because this comes up, like this alone thing has come up a lot for a lot of women who are in my groups, who I've talked to, like a lot of women feel alone and I don't want you to feel alone. So I'm really glad you're here because you're not alone. You're with me. Ah, you're with me right now. Let me take a sip. So the last way you cannot feel alone or feel like you're like floating out in the ether of your business is to join a group program or to join, to work with a coach one-on-one, to make an investment, to up-level your learning, have someone who's ahead of you to talk to. That's something I did about a year and a half ago. I started working with a coach. I didn't even know coaches really existed, to be honest, before that. So if it's not me, I can highly suggest other people depending on what you're looking for. I know we have people from all sorts of businesses on here. If you're a boutique, retail, product-based entrepreneur, I'm a great coach, blah, blah. right? No more self-doubt. Like, I'm a great coach. But if you're not and you need something specific, or you're looking for someone else to work with, I have a huge network of amazing women who, you know, if you want to, like, open a crystal shop, like, I can help you find someone who's like really great in the spiritual world who can help you, you know, work through that. Or if you're having money mindset issues, I have awesome mindset coaches that I can refer you to. So, you know, that's the thing too. At a certain point, guys, like in your business, to take your business to the next level, you have to take it seriously. And you have to decide you want to take it seriously. So there are lots of free options, and then there are lots of investment options. Yeah, as a boutique owner. Yeah, so maybe there's another boutique owner. You know, that's a great, use Fashion Truck Tribe and ask in there and say, hey, is there anyone that wants to maybe be a mastermind partner with me this year? And we set goals and we talk every week. And my hair's looking crazy. And that is totally something you can do. You know, if you, I know that one of my good friends is in direct sales for Rodin and Fields, and, for Rodin and Fields, you know, they call them power partners. And she's like, I need a new power partner who's going to like link up with me and really support each other. Right. So whether it's a power partner, mastermind partner, whatever that means, there are definitely options out there for you. That's actually one of the reasons I want to start my membership site, because it's going to be a low cost investment to get a lot of support and training and have some extra interaction with me so that you don't feel alone, right? Like this is one of the things I'm trying to do, is trying to give people options so that they can grow their business in ways that feel great. I'm a great coach. Thanks, Nancy. Nancy's a great client. I love Nancy. Nancy is an amazing health coach, guys. If you are looking to, and getting a coach is key. Yeah, totally. Donna, I can't wait to start Rodin and Fields. Are you going to sell Rodin and Fields, Donna? Yes, I can't wait. Are you going to be a consultant, Donna, for Rodin and Fields? I was a consultant for a little while. It's a really great company. So you guys, there are lots of options. What I will tell you to do, because I think we should wrap up. It feels like it's a wrapping up moment. I feel like I need to put another log on the fire too. It's going out. So that means I've been here too. Awesome, Donna. I love Rodin and Fields. It's great products. It's a great company. as is 31. I know we have a 31 consultant, LuLaRoe. There are many great companies, I think, that are direct sales. And I love multi-level marketing direct sales companies because you're like set up with a business. So it's pretty cool. Okay. So if you have questions, if you need help with any of this, if you feel like you need anything, please feel free to reach out to me, whether it's direct message or my email. My email is emily@stylishandsuccessful.com. If you feel like you need more support, if you feel like you have more questions, like anything, I'm here. I'm a real person. I actually, Nancy, we met in person for the past month, and we worked together in person, which was freaking awesome because we like got too much done, which is awesome. But I do offer free sessions every now and again. I do offer as much advice as I can give, with what I know to help you. And then, when you're ready to work with me or someone else, awesome. Like, it's a really good thing to, if you're going to take your business seriously, like Nancy said, working with a coach is so important, or joining a group program, something like that, is a great option for you. But, and it also, relating back to what this workshop is all about, hitting your big goals, it is accountability, right? Share the book list. Yeah, I can post some books. Absolutely, Claudine. Claudine, can you send me a direct message? Can you send me a private message and I will send you some books? And I'll post a couple below. And what else? Yeah, let me know what you guys need. Let me just quickly review the three steps that we talked about today. Thank you. If you stayed on this whole time, I think it's been like 8 hours. The sun's like setting. If you've been on this whole time, amazing. Thank you from the bottom of my heart for joining me. I really had this like download the other day that I feel like it's so important for us all to, am I doing a program? I do a couple different programs. I have one-on-one coaching. I have a group program called the Six Figure Blueprint. And let me look at my yearly thing. I'm not launching anything else for like another month. but I do have two options. So Donna, I can send you information. I'll send you a direct message, okay? Maybe we can just talk. I'd love to just catch up and see what you're doing right now. Thank you. Thanks to Nancy. Yeah, thank you, Nancy. You're awesome. So three steps to hitting your big goals. One, let that shit go. Let anything go from this year that is holding you back, that has held you back. Write it all out, burn it, rip it up, let it go. Okay. Two is write those big goals down. What are those goals and what are the mini steps that you need to get there? And then put it on a timeline, right? Put it on a time. When are you going to be able to do it? You're not going to do it all in January, let me tell you, right? You're not going to become the top real estate agent in January. Maybe you will, but like, let's be realistic. Third is every single day, get a routine down that helps you achieve those goals. Whether it's meditating, whether it's affirmations, whether it's subliminal messaging, whether it's writing your goals down once or twice a day, that's a great one. Whatever it is, maybe you need to read a little bit of a book every day that keeps your mindset on track. And I'll post some of those below. But every single day, guys, like, you got to get on it, right? The only way to do big things is to commit to allowing yourself to do those big things and to putting yourself on the track to doing those big things. So I am so excited for each and every one of you. 2017 is going to be kick-ass. Mark my words, December 31st, 2016. In a year, things are going to look very different for you. They're going to look really different for me. So let's decide what that is now. Let's have an awesome New Year's Eve. And let's move into 2017 feeling good. You know, maybe you need to take a bath tonight. Maybe you want to burn some candles. Maybe you want to take it slow. I'm taking it slow. I've been taking it slow all week because the holidays were a lot for me. So I am taking it slow this week. And probably the next time you see me on live stream, I will be in Guatemala. We are leaving on Wednesday for Guatemala for 3 entire months. I'm so excited. And this is one of our dreams. We're like going for it. We're going to live in another country for 3 entire months, which is something we haven't yet done. So I'm really excited. So I'll be packing for the next 4 days and like buying things in the US that I can't get there. But thank you so much for joining me, you guys. I love sharing my knowledge with you. I love when you show up authentically and completely and you're engaged and involved. It just makes my heart so happy. So I'm going to say goodbye. This replay will be up. I'll also throw this on YouTube in the next couple days. So you can watch it on YouTube as well. I know YouTube streams a little bit better than Facebook Lives. I know Facebook Live has some buffering issues. So I'll post the link to replay it, the link to the replay to YouTube as well. But I'm going to wrap up. I'm going to say thank you so much. Thank you. I'll just end there. You guys all know who I am by now. Thank you so much and happy freaking New Year. Bye.